This video is about irrational numbers and square roots. First, we have to recall the definition of rational and irrational numbers. Rational numbers can be expressed as terminating or repeating decimals, while irrational numbers can be expressed as non-terminating and non-repeating decimals. Now, to discuss the parts of square roots, we have the following. The symbol is what you call as the radical symbol. The part underneath the radical symbol is what we call as the radicand, and the radicand and the radical symbol combined together is what we call as the radical. Another thing you have to know about square roots is that squaring a number means multiplying the number by itself. So let's say, for example, if we have 3 raised to the power of 2, it can be expressed as 3 times 3, which is equal to 9. The exponent of 2 means that the number should be multiplied by itself 2 times. So if we have the square of negative 3, that means negative 3 times negative 3, which is equal to positive 9. A non-integer number can also be squared. If we have the square of 1.4, it means multiplying 1.4 by itself 2 times, which is equal to 1.96. Please take note. Every non-zero real number has 2 square roots, one positive and one negative. The positive square root is actually what you call as the principal square root. Let's say, for example, we are to identify the principal square root of the following numbers. The square root of 25 would be equal to positive 5, square root of 64 would be equal to positive 8, and square root of 144 is equal to positive 12. Please take note that the square roots of negative real numbers are not real numbers. Let's say, for example, if we have square root of negative 4, the radicand is a negative real number. The value of this would give you an unreal number, which is an imaginary number. And that would be discussed in the next level of mathematics. Now, open your Schoology and give the principal square root of the following numbers.